a lot of us, if you know anything about rank 9, it's something that's quite easy to aspire to, desire rank 9, right? You see those people on the beach and you get a little bit jealous and you say, ooh, I wish I could be rank 9. And so what this development seminar is about looking at fundamental personal activity and attitude to getting yourself to rank 9 and beyond. Remember, rank 9 is just a stepping stone, right? It's just this one rank in many ranks to come that kind of show your progress as you build towards sustainable wealth that you've created for yourself. And so if we have a little closer look as to what rank 9 is, it is a requirement of having 1,000 products in your qualified channel. Right, and now that would also be an awesome aspiration. Imagine opening your app and you've got 1,000 qualified paid for products and you see that return that Dewpoint's going to be paying you sitting at around 20,000 Rand. Right, your XP requirement is almost 500,000 XP. So XP is experience points. If you're brand new, we've kind of shown you what the XP rewards program is a little bit about, but you have to earn XP. Fortunately, we've made it very easy for you to earn XP, and so getting to 500,000 XP is not that difficult anymore. And so that becomes the aspiration when we talk about reaching rank 9. That's what it looks like. And you end up on a yacht with a whole bunch of other people towards the end of the year, and you get to enjoy it every single year. Right? Because when your channel is sitting at 1,000 and growing, at the end of every single year, you will have more than 1,000 people in your channel. And so every single year, you will get an invitation from Dewpoint saying, we invite you and your family to our Rank 9 International Conference again and again and again and again. And the liberty that affords. I was reading an article about the benefits of children who get to travel internationally. Do you know that there's psychological benefits to children that get to travel outside of their country? There are. And so it opens up this world of possibilities to you and your family, right? It opens up your aspirations and what's possible in this lifetime. And so rank 9 is a very powerful rank to get to. And so the three fundamental things that we're going to be looking today start with leverage. We discussed it a little bit. I alluded to leverage in the intro presentation earlier, but leverage is so fundamental to this business. If you don't have an appreciation of leverage and what that affords you in this business, you will never get anywhere in this business, right? And we're going to expand on that a little bit. And then endurance. Endurance, people mistake endurance as this characteristic that you are born with. It most certainly isn't. Right? Endurance is something you develop. It is something you develop. You start at zero. You start with zero endurance. But when you are brave enough, when you have courage to step into a process, that's where endurance is built. Right? And so we're going to look at the power of endurance. And then finally, vision. I alluded to this again in the intro presentation. Allowing your imagination to run wild. Right? How do you see Dewpoint? What is your vision for yourself with regards to your partnership in Dewpoint? We're going to look at that because that often dictates your attitude going forward. And if your attitude isn't right in this business, then you're not going to achieve what Dewpoint hopes you will achieve. We often have aspirations greater than your own. I don't want that to be patronizing, but think about that. Have you ever had someone in your life that expects more from you than you expect of yourself? That is very motivating to have someone like that in your life, right? Someone that is willing to be next to you, to pick you up when you need to be picked up. We all need that. And so we're going to be talking about vision as the final kind of fundamental key to the road to rank 9. All right, so let's start with leverage. You will know that we often talk about this principle of 3+2, right? Getting involved in this business and kind of the basis for any wealth engineer is to be able to achieve 3+2. 3 means that you connect 3 people in your first month, all right? And the 2 means every consecutive month thereafter. So in your first month, get 3. Why? Because that's where we start paying. That's when you become a qualified wealth engineer in our business. That is what unlocks income, is 3 people, right? And then we say, and then you just have to sustain it by connecting 2 people every single month. So that is the basis for duplication in our business. We call it 3+2. And the 3+2 is what unlocks duplication. It It's the thing that unlocks leverage. Now, I don't want to jump past leverage and expect everyone to just, I will assume everyone knows what leverage means. So here's the mechanical principle of leverage, right? We will all know this. If you take a lever, right, and you put it on something like a crowbar and you want to lift a rock, right, if that crowbar is long enough, you can push it against something and lift a rock much heavier than you. That is the basic mechanical principle around leverage, right? So we've got Einstein sitting there and he says to us, using a lever makes light work of lifting a heavy load. The effort force, so the force that you have to put down on that lever, is much less than the force that you are trying to load, right? So this is the general principle of mechanical force. And there you can see he's pushing his hand down on the pink lever, you've got the long lever, and then you've got a very important part of leverage, and that is the fulcrum. The fulcrum is what you're balancing the lever on, right? It is always closer to the load and further away from you, and then we've got that little gold rock there, whatever it is. That is the load that you're trying to lift. And so we've got a lot of physical benefits to the principle of leverage. Mechanical advantage, it makes it easier, right, if you employ leverage. It has a velocity benefit, so it allows you to operate faster, right? So things can happen quicker. And then you've got efficiency. Efficiency means if it's easier and it's faster, you become more efficient. You get to expend less stress around trying to get something done, right? And so these are the basic physics of leverage. Now, what is dew point leverage? And here we've got a wonderful quote that we sent out on our Facebook yesterday by Archimedes. Give me a lever long enough and a fulcrum strong enough, and I will be able to move the earth. And that is what dew point employs. We employ leverage here. We give you the benefit of leverage in this business, right? And so if we look at leverage from a dew point perspective, dew point, the dew point system is the fulcrum. You see that blue little triangle there? We are the system. The fulcrum has to be strong. It has to be strong. There are many business opportunities that bandy around this benefit of, oh, we also got duplication here, right? Network marketing, that is one of the premises of network marketing. But why do so many of those businesses fail when you start to exert more force on them? Is because the system, the backbone of those businesses are not strong. They are weak. Here at Dew Point, we have built a strong business with a strong backbone. We have invested technology and money into this business. So no matter what the force is that you employ on the lever, you can lift whatever you want. If you want to connect 1,000 people in a day, our systems do it like that. We are one of the few businesses that have moved onto Microsoft's Azure cloud platform in South Africa. One of the first, right? That hosting costs us, just to host our system on the Azure platform, costs us 50,000 Rand a month. Why do we do it? Because we need a strong fulcrum for wealth engineers to be able to leverage the power of this business without the business, the system failing. And so you can put in very little effort. You can go out and connect 100 people and suddenly have 1,000 people in your business. That is only by leverage. You want to get to rank 9? You don't have to connect 1,000 people yourself. You employ leverage. You go out and you find 100 people, of which only a handful will go out and do the work. And together in community, working together, the collaboration, the leverage that exists, you will achieve 1,000 people in your qualified channel. That suddenly affords you a return of 20,000 Rand a month, right? And so I hope you appreciate what leverage is. We have to understand what leverage is to appreciate it. 3 plus 2. So here's a little quote from Brendan. He wants to be famous. Promises become reality when you get paid. When that line item comes up on your statement, when you get an SMS from the bank saying your account has been credited, you read it again. You say, credited. What does credited mean? I don't know credited. I've never seen that before in my life. I've only seen debited. Right? When you get that SMS that says, when the bank tells you you've been credited with 165 Rand, because that's where we start, right? 55 Rand times 3 people that you've connected. That's why the 3 is so important. The 3 is not arbitrary. The 3 is what unlocks you earning. And it is what unlocks duplication. Because the people that you bring into the business, unless they start earning, they will not really become believers of Dewpoint. And so it not only becomes your ambition to get three people as quickly as possible, but for you to support and assist and help those people that you connect to the business to getting their own three people. Because when your first pointers start earning money, that's when you create believers in the business. Believers become builders in the business, right? People that don't earn money in the business, they aren't the ones that are going to hang around, right? And so, beyond just you becoming qualified and earning, get your first pointers qualified and earning. And the moment you've got first pointers that start qualifying themselves and earning, they open up your qualified channel, right? And so that three, that number three, is very important in terms of unlocking duplication. And start now. Get your three as soon as possible. You have everything that you need in this business. There should never, ever be a wealth engineer that joins this business that goes, I don't know what to do, right? For one, you've got a lead wealth engineer that has already been in the business, right? And your success is not predicated on your lead wealth engineer. Your success is your responsibility, right? And so if you think, you don't like your lead wealth engineer, it doesn't matter. If your lead wealth engineer is not active, it does not matter, right? But for a lot of us, we've got lead wealth engineers that we can lean on. At the same time, you've got an entire business that has created an infrastructure of support that you can lean on. And so there should never be anyone joining this business that is unaware of what that infrastructure is, right? And we've got all these. So here's a couple of dev seminars that I'd like to highlight. A message worth telling, right, about prospecting, inviting, and connecting. That is the lifeblood of creating a channel. Your first 30 days. Like as a brand new person, what should I expect? What should I be doing? There it is. In 50 minutes, it'll explain everything to you that you have to do, right? This business is a rinse and repeat business. If you can put in three, you can put in 3,000. So go watch that dev seminar. And then the fast starter guide, right? This is a fast starter guide that it's something, I don't even know if people use the fast starter guide. Don't tell me you don't use it, you'll upset me. But go look at the Fast Starter Guide. It is set up like a training program, right? It's a nice tabular format. It tells you everything that you should be doing, when you should be doing it in your first month at Dewpoint. And so we've spelt everything out, not only for your benefit to build yourself, but for the benefit of the people you connect to the business. Because it is so easy to send someone a WhatsApp and say, have you watched this dev seminar? It takes you 5 seconds to do that. Right? And so be aware of all the support so that people can get started as quickly as possible. Do not wait for people to ponder and get back into their comfortable lives. You have to strike while the iron's hot. You've got to apply the pressure. Pressure that should be exciting, not stressful. Exciting pressure. You can do this. Get three people. Start earning. You can do three. You can do 3,000. What does that unlock for you if you've got 3,000 people in your business? The XP Rewards Program. So if you open up your app, you will notice under Rewards, all the quests come up. We've got 25 different quests, and our quests reflect all these fundamentals that we discussed. They are not arbitrary, right? And so here's one that talks about 3+2. We've got the Business Boss. Can you get 5 new people into the business that pay successfully in the same month? There's XP that you get awarded for doing that. We highlight this because we want to challenge people to do these quests. For your benefit, the lightning qualifier. Have a first pointer in your business that qualifies themselves in the same month that they join. Whew, that's magic. If you're a wealth engineer, you know that's magic. If you've got someone that joins your business and they get qualified in the same month they joined, you're like, whoo, you see the money. You see the money and the gold, right? Because those people are few and far between. But aspire to that, right? Figure out, how do I get people to do that? And then 3+2, if you can achieve 3+2, 3 in your first month and 2 for the next 5 months, then you've conquered the 3+2 quest. Aspire to these things. Make sure that your people that you connect to the business are aware of all these quests, because the quests are there to challenge you. And if you challenge yourself and you're able to conquer some of these quests, you are building wealth in the process. And you are building a routine, a repertoire that is built for creating wealth in this business, right? These are not arbitrary quests. Engage in the duplication. So, number one, learn. You have to learn yourself. You've got to immerse yourself into this business. And like I said earlier in the intro presentation, it's not a 5-year degree. 5-year degrees don't create wealth. They create stress when you come out. Right? I was looking at the U.S. You know, you go study medicine in the U.S. They give, the government gives out grants to go study, but you've got to pay them back, right? The amount of money that students owe the U.S. government in the States exceeds South Africa's GDP. Over 1 trillion rand is what students in the U.S. owe the U.S. government. But now I'm getting off topic. Right? What I'm saying is that to understand principles of wealth and building a channel at Dewpoint is not a 5-year process. It's not going to cost you anything. The knowledge is free for you to immerse yourself in. Go become an expert as quickly as possible in the Dewpoint system. It can only benefit you. And we don't only discuss principles specific, practicality specific to Dewpoint. We discuss all kinds of things that can benefit you in all manners of life, right? And so go immerse yourself. The dev seminars, your lead wealth engineer that might have experienced a lot of things. Ask them, speak to them. And then you need to demonstrate what you've learned. Because when you start doing the business, to empower the people that you connect into the business has to be done through practical demonstration. You've got to show people what you're doing and that it works. Right? Otherwise, it's all theory. It's just theory. Theory has no power unless it's put into practice. Right? And lead by example. Always, always lead by example. You've got a picture. That requires accountability, unfortunately, right? A lot of us enter into this business thinking it's kind of like a hobby. Hopefully, I'm going to make some money. I'm going to do it when I feel like it. And we come and go. We allow our circumstances, our emotions to dictate what we're doing on a day-to-day basis. Unfortunately, that is being witnessed by all your first pointers. You know, I'm a parent to young kids. And there's that saying, Don't tell your kids what to do. You've got to show them what to do. Otherwise, they won't learn. If you're doing one thing and telling them another thing, they're going to do what you're doing, not what you're telling them. It's the same for first pointers. You've got to show them. You've got to take on this behavior of a responsible wealth engineer, lead wealth engineer, of a leader. Some people think leadership is about management. It's not about management. It's about just conducting yourself responsibly so that the people that are joining you in your business do the same thing. If I can be active all the time, if I can get qualified quickly, if I can know Dewpoint back to front because I've looked at all the dev seminars, if I know what all the quests are, and if I've got first pointers that start duplicating that behavior, success is inevitable. But if I have a bad week and I'm feeling a bit stressed and I don't speak to any of my first pointers for a whole month. Imagine we closed the doors for a month. Rob and Brendan didn't pitch up for a whole month. You couldn't get into the office. There were no live streams. What would your impression be of Dewpoint all of a sudden? After 4 years, what would your impression suddenly change to in an instant? They got us! They got us! Where are they? Where are they? What island are they gone to? They took our money. Right? That same responsibility falls upon your shoulders. And again, it's not to manage people. It's just to conduct yourselves responsibly so that the people below you do the same thing so that you can become successful in this business. Right? So those are the three things. Get involved with your people. This is a community business. Get your hands dirty. Get your hands dirty. Don't grope any of them, but get your hands dirty. What does that mean? It means having face-to-face interactions with people. Don't be shy face-to-face. I know a lot of people now are starting to prospect online and in social media. It doesn't stop you from pressing into wanting to meet people face-to-face, right? There will be opportunity that maybe someone's out of town, but there'll be opportunity that maybe you're going to be near them one day, or maybe you're going to go out and visit them. Right? But press into face-to-face communication. I've got a friend who works in New York. He's got a consultancy. And he says, you know, with all the technology, he says, I can conference call people around the world. He's got clients around the world. He says, but at the end of the day, I have to get on a plane and go see those people if I want business from them. I have to see them face-to-face. I have to create rapport. It's the same with your first pointers. regular communications and meetings. Like I said, what would you think of Dewpoint if suddenly we closed the office for a week and you couldn't get hold of us and there were no live streams, no communication, no Facebook posts? Same for you. Communicate regularly with your first pointers. So easy to do online as well. Demonstrate the correct use of social media. Right? Social media can be a trap for a lot of us because we make a lot of mistakes. I hope you've went and looked at the latest social media development seminar so that you don't fall into those traps. And so when people join your business, you've got to make sure that they're not falling into those traps too, right? Social media is becoming very prevalent at the moment. It's awesome, but use it properly and responsibly. Target and goal setting. Target and goal setting is not, this is how much money I want to earn by December. Target and goal setting is finding out the need in the person's heart that has joined your business. Every single one of us are unique. We've got different pain points. We've got different necessity. We have different reasons why we've joined the business. It is your responsibility to go find out what that need is. You should have found out the need before they joined because Dewpoint was there to answer that need. Right? I want to change my life. I've been retrenched. I'm going to lose my car. I'm trying to send my kids to a better school. Whatever that need is, you need to understand it. That is what target and goal setting is. It's not a number and a date only. Right? It is about knowing somebody, knowing each individual that I'm counting on to help and for them to help me, for us both to build wealth in this business. Teach the formula. Drive more than 3 plus 2. I said 3 plus 2 is the basis. It is the starting point, right? You can certainly exceed it. There is so much more for you if you exceed 3 plus 2. And so drive it. Let it become an ambition. Don't say to people, oh, well, minimum is 3 plus 2. I mean, who wants to do the minimum? Achiever's Quest is wonderful for that. Do 10 people in a month. Imagine all your first pointers hit Achiever Quest. Just imagine that. That starts to unlock some crazy numbers, right? But unless you push that ambition, it'll never happen. The 365 challenge. How many people have actually sat down and tried to work out doing the 365 challenge? What it means practically on a day-to-day basis? Or do we just skim over it and go, oh no, maybe only one or two people do that. That's not for me. That's not for me. Right? But unless you, as the lead wealth engineer, are saying to people, have you considered the 365 challenge? Right? There's a couple of strategy devs that Dewpoint have done, a couple of interviews with the big guys that they've done. Let's look at those. Maybe you can do 365. Maybe you can be that person that becomes a millionaire in a year at Dewpoint. You get to walk up onto stage with a 365,000 rand cash check, where everyone looks at you knowing that that person in 12 months is now suddenly earning 50,000 rand a month out of Dewpoint. And they are still going. Six in the first month's good. 10's even better. Yeah, like Brendan says, 10 in the first month, those people become your new best friend. Is there anything I can get you? Are you okay? Do you need a back rub? When someone's building that fast on your first point, they become diamonds to you. 30 in the first month is future changed forever. When you find that diamond, right? And statistically, you will find that person. If you keep pushing and you keep prospering, you're going to find those people. It might not happen in your first year. It might not happen in your third year. But it's going to happen. If you keep pushing, you're going to find this person that comes and blows Dewpoint out the water with the amount of business that they bring in. Right? And so let these become ambitions for you and teach that formula. Teach the formula. Perform the formula successfully. Show people how this business is done. It's not complicated. You have to show them how to connect one person. Not how to connect 1,000, you have to show them how to connect one person successfully. You can demonstrate it with your own guests. You can demonstrate it to their guests. That's demonstrating, right? I will come with you. Have you got people coming to the house? I will come with you to the house. I'll show you how we get them signed up. Demonstrate that formula, your formula, successfully. And then schedule regular Teamworks meetings. This is your opportunity to engage with head office. Right, you can come and ask us anything. You can say, look, I've been doing this for 3 months. I'm struggling with these people. I've got these people. I'm trying to do this stuff online, and I'm not getting anywhere. We will spend an hour with you and your team personally trying to help you overcome obstacles in this business. And then always be available. We've touched on this already. Always be available. Always in communication. Always there. Even if you're on holiday, you're still there. Right? Technology allows for that. There's no excuses for being in a dark hole. Silence, white noise. There's no excuse for that. Okay? So teach the formula, perform it successfully. And then again, the quests in our XP rewards program reflect all these principles that we've been speaking about. Log in daily, right? The launch workshop. Have you come to see a launch workshop? Have your first pointers all been involved in a launch workshop? The prospector, register prospects. That again is your lifeblood. You should see that number going up every single day. Watch it. Come to intro presentations yourself. Why? You might go, I've seen the intro presentation already. Because you're demonstrating engagement with the business to your first pointers. If they never see you at an intro because you saw the first one, what does that demonstrate to the people that you're building business with? Right? And so it becomes very important. And I promise, we try to change the intro every now and again just to surprise you. One day there will be 2,500 rand under the chairs and you'll regret not being it. The learner. Watch the dev seminars. So how long does it take you to watch a dev seminar once we released a new dev seminar? Like today, how long is it going to take for you guys to communicate to your channel that the dev has happened and that it'll help you and that you can't lose by watching this dev seminar, right? You can only benefit. There's a beautiful quote about knowledge. Knowledge can never be taken away from you. Never. We've got the introducer. Are you showing the intro presentations to prospects? That prospector number and the introducer number, they should be tracking each other. Qualifying. Get qualified. Take a selfie. Brendan came and told me something. He said, you know what? There are people taking selfies of dogs and pot plants and all kinds of things. I looked at all the ladies in client service and said, why on earth would anyone do that? And they were like, oh, I don't know. Maybe the dog's better looking than the person. I don't know. We reverse that XP. We see you taking a selfie of the dog. We reverse that XP. Guys, we put that there, right? This is not important. Taking a selfie is not important. But what it allows you to do is engage with brand new first pointers. Come, let me show you how to earn 1,000 XP immediately. Right? They go, wow, I've got 1,000 XP already. Right? Progress. That's what the selfie demonstrates. Ranking up should be everyone's ambition. Opening channel points, getting qualified wealth engineers in your first point. Team leader, hosting team meetings with your first pointers. Right? These are all behavior things that allow you to build wealth. Attend dew point encounters. We've got these encounters around the country. Please, never get to the end of the year and you've not gone to one encounter. See, I'm watching all of you. Bombela encounters coming up, right? I can pull a report that says who has not been to an encounter. Teamworks meetings, we've spoken about that, and then the generator leadership workshops. That happens when you rank 4 and above. So when you get to rank 4, suddenly you start getting more attention. Dewpoint starts looking at you and starts customizing development purely for those rank 4s, right? Because these are the people that have been enduring for such an amount of time that we go, right, let's try help these people get to the next step. What's after rank 4? Rank 9, rank 14. And so that should become an ambition too for you.
Hi, I went home and I go and listen to watch the live stream. After the live stream, I was so crazy now. I'm starting phoning my people now. Guys, can we meet tomorrow? What is wrong now? What is, please, can we meet tomorrow? 10:30 in my office. I said, oh, okay, we are coming. What is new now? Just, wait and see. I'll tell you. I said, okay, it's fine. And then I came here. The first person that I met, I remember it was Chichi Bombo by Spe. I said, Spa, where are you? I said, I'm about to go to the office. I said, no, you know what? Can we meet at Spa? I said, why at Spa? You want to buy me something? I said, yes, let's go and have a breakfast meeting. I said, okay, it's fine. Let's meet there. When I met Chichi, I said, Chichi, can I show you something? I said, what? No, I want to show you something, but I don't want to work with Devin people. I want my first line and second line to be the people that are out from Devin. I said, what is this now? I said, wait. And then I open my laptop, go through to my videos, I'm hoping for all those things that are shown. She said, Spa, please, can you please register me now? Because I've got some people that I need to show them this. I need to send. lady, she was working. There's a company at IFA. She was working for IFA. So she said, please, I've got some people spark. I need some. Please just do me a favor. I need the number. I need the world engineer number. We call it link. It's something like a link. I need the link for this. I said, okay, I'll do that. Did register Chichi. That time, that particular day, there was people that Chichi, she was waiting for them. They came. After they came, they said, she said, Spa, please do me a favor. Just tell these people all those things that we are telling. I said, what? What is going on? I said, please just tell them. Do me a favor. Tell them. I said, okay, it's fine. I will do that. Let me go to YouTube. I went to YouTube and I opened some videos and I played for them. And the other lady, she was working for another company. I don't want to mention them. First time, first day, he said, please, Chichi, I'm your first daughter now. Can you please sign me? I said, okay, I'll do that. We did have to sign him. The Chichi, let us go to the office. There is no one in the office now. Let's go back to the office. Again, when I came here, Shwara, she was also here now. He said, please sponsor Mkulu. He called like sponsor Mkulu. Please sponsor Mkulu. Tell me what's wrong with you? Even yesterday you were like this. Even now you're like this. Tell me what is wrong with you. I said, this is the good time now. I can tell you now. And then I opened my laptop. I said, can you please do me a favor? Just listen to this video. Just listen to the video. After this video, just call me. Because I was busy with the phone. And then she listened to the videos. After that, she was standing. She said, please, sponsor, can you please sign me in? I'm in love with this. And then, why are you in love with this? What is it? I said, please. I know this is the business that I was looking for. The first month, for me, the first month was like the 19th till 31st. For me, it was like first month, but what I'm hip about it, I get paid on that 19th.
How much did you get paid?
It was 550-something rent. Yeah, I'm not sure about it, but it was 550-something rent. That was my first salary from.
And how was your November?
Oh my goodness, November, it's like I'm speechless for November. I'm speechless for November. I was not even aware, but I remember Pumi found me. It was like 5:30 or 6:30. He said, Spa, where are you? I said, no, I'm home. Have you ever gone and opened the site, your site? Have you opened your site yet? I said, no, I didn't open. Let's just go and check your business. Your business is growing, and I'm scared now. What is going on now? I said, what is all about? I said, just go and open it. And when I go, I remember that day, it was like 2,000 rand paid members. 2,000 rand from 500 rand. Now it's almost 2,000 rand. The following day, the money was growing. The following week, the money was growing. I was like, no, this thing is too much now. This thing is too much now. It's not for me. Because now it's just a magic. November, it was 4,700 and something rent. 4,700 and something rent. Even there, I was like, I don't know. I don't know what is going on. Yeah, I was so excited. Even now, I'm so excited.
That man set Durban alight. It's one of my favorite testimonies, man. Just the passion. And he just shows off leverage. He never convinced anyone to join. He said, I went to YouTube, I turned on the presentation, and people were like, I'll join. It looks great. Right? One of my favorite testimonies from Spamandla in Durban. And so he has leverage demonstrated again. Right? Here are some of the wealth engineers that we've had up on Talal Tuesday in the last year or so. 13 people on their first point, 370 people in their channel. So you can see those ratios that exist. That ratio is all about leverage. You don't have to go find 1,000 people to join your business. Go find a handful of good people. Support them. Love them. Find out about them. Find out what their needs are. Find out what they want Dewpoint to do for them and help them achieve it. That's all you have to do in this business. It's not about convincing people that this that they need dew point. It's just showing them the opportunity that they're free to join or to walk away from. More leverage demonstrated. So here's some wonderful numbers. This is a couple of facts that some of our wealth engineers have shared with us. Donnie last month said, you know, in the last 48 hours, 54 people joined my channel. And he didn't connect a single one of them. He just opened his app and saw that number, 54 in the first 48 hours. Lynette and Fricky, 750 people in a single month. That's nearly going rank 9 in a single month. In 1 month, and that's brand new people. That's leverage. And then Patrick and Pumi, on the first day when we run debit orders on the first day of the month, right? We got debit orders that spread throughout the month. But on the first day of the month, Patrick and Pumi have already got 1,000 products in their qualified channel paid for. This is leverage. This is leverage. If you are connecting people into dew point and you are not experiencing duplication, there is a problem, right? You have to be aware of your business. Be aware of what your first pointers are doing and not doing. You have to tap into the leverage side of it, the duplication side of it. It is fundamental to your success in this business. Otherwise, you're just a commission-based salesperson trying to get 1,000 people in on your own. Our business is not built on that, all right? Wealth leveraged. The power of recurring income affords you leverage. If you wanted a bank account, a balance, a cash balance to pay you out 1,000 rand of interest a month, right? So a cash balance that affords you 5% interest annually, you would need 240,000 rand of cash in a bank account. That would give you 1,000 rand recurring income in the form of interest every single month. You want to do 100,000 rand per month, that's 24 million rand you need in a bank account. Right, we've got wealth engineers that have already got up to that. We have to understand the power of money, of recurring income. Recurring income gives you leverage, right? And so there are many facets of leverage in our business. We have to appreciate this. And then going the distance. I'm going to speak about endurance now, and this is one of my favorite topics because often what people do is they dismiss endurance as a characteristic that is inherent to some people and not to other people, which is a complete fallacy, right? Endurance is something that starts at zero. We all start with no endurance. But when you have the courage to step into a process that challenges you, that is where endurance starts to grow in you. And so we all have the ability to grow endurance within ourselves. Headed for success. Endurance is the ultimate requirement for building wealth. Not only in this business, in life. Hands down. Undisputable fact. Right? And so immediately you've got to appreciate that I have to start building endurance in myself. He has a lovely description on Wikipedia of what endurance is. Your ability to exert yourself and remain active for a long period of time, as well as your ability to resist, to withstand and to recover from and have immunity to trauma and wounds and fatigue. But then this very wise man from Dew Point, his name's Rob, came up with his Dew Point definition of endurance. Your ability to connect new people and to keep connecting new people for at least 5 years, as well as your ability to resist, withstand, recover from, and immunity to rejection and failed payments, cancellations, and the circumstances of life around you. That is endurance, Rob the Wise. You like that? Oh! If you're willing to endure, if you're willing to take that on, if you're willing to make a decision and say, okay, I'll accept that I need endurance to build wealth in my life, right? If you're willing to enter into that race, you will become successful, right? And so I chose this picture. You can see there's three ladies helping this one lady who is stumbling to try to get to the line. That is Dew Point. You're not doing it on your own. You've got business. You've got support structures. You've got people that have invested money into systems to allow you to enjoy the support of trying to make you successful. You've got lead wealth engineers, you've got first pointers, you've got an entire channel, you've got thousands of people helping you, people you don't even know, that are pushing you along a little bit by little bit. But the one thing that'll cause all of that to fall down is when you decide to give up. When you decide to quit. Right? In races like this, you walk to the side, they pull your number off. They do. You see it in very dramatic fashion in the Tour de France. The cyclists get off their bike, the commissar comes up to them, tears the number off. You're done. But if you don't give up, no matter how jelly-like your legs feel, if you keep pushing, even if you're going along slowly, we will help you along. You will get to that finish line, whatever your finish line is. Right? Trying equals progress. Quitting is what ends it. And so we have to take on rejection. But don't take it on personally. Right? We all get all these. Right? How many reactions have you got when you try to approach someone? I'm sure there have been a range of reactions. You might have the people like, ah, your friends. What? You get the, oh no, those businesses. Those businesses. You even get the rude granny. You will experience all these reactions. All of them. Right? This is one of the fundamental aspects to endurance. When we talk about endurance, enduring rejection, this is what we have to endure. Right, and then the worst person, at least the other ones tell you where to go. The last one's like, keep you hanging for weeks, for months, right? You need about 100 personal connections to get to rank 9, statistically. So we've looked at the data, and personal connections are not people that join. It's just you showing people the intro presentation. For 100 people to sit down and watch that 35-minute, or this morning, 45-minute intro presentation, that's going to get you to rank 9. Statistically, right? And so when we talk about endurance, when I say to you, this is what I'm offering you, do you accept to endure this or not? I'm saying to you, are you willing to go find 100 people to sit down and watch the intro presentation to get you to 20,000 rand a month, to rank 9, to be able to invite your family to Mauritius every single year? That's the invitation, right? And so you can look at it practically. You can go, okay, this is the race. This is the race I'm going to enter. I know it's going to hurt, but I'm going to enter into it. At the same time, I don't want you to take on rejection personally. When people say no to the business, that is just a reflection of where they are at that point in their lives, right? They might have been hurt by the business opportunities. They might be stressed in other parts of their life. They don't need anything more. It doesn't matter. The point is that you don't take on that rejection personally, because if you take on the rejection personally, it is going to affect you dramatically. When you go out and prospect, you have to treat people as numbers, unfortunately, right? But then when you start to build rapport and people join you, that's when you can let out the human aspect. That's when you can start becoming a little more emotionally tied to these people. But when it's prospecting, it's just numbers. People are going to say yes and no, yes and no, yes and no, 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 yes, yes, no, 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 no. If every no is a rejection that you feel personally, you need to figure out how to get over that, right? Because entrepreneurship comes with rejection. There are so many stories and testimonies from successful entrepreneurs that tell you about the unending rejection they experienced. Right? Lots of stories like that. And so be aware of that. So out of the 100 personal connections, it's going to result in about 50 people per annum, because rank 9 takes between 18 months and 2 years to do at 3 plus 2. It means that you've got to connect 4 people per month, right? One person a month. You've got to go, 1 person a week. You've got to show 1 person a week the intro presentation. The result of that will be 2 people joining. All right? So that's the given ratio. You might do less than that. You might do more than that. You have to be aware of what your ratio is. If you are prospecting on social media, you know you have to go through volume. If you're doing only face-to-face, you don't have to go through that much volume. Be aware of your numbers. Don't be blind to your numbers. Then you're blind to what's happening in your business. Be aware. This is how many people I speak to, how many people I pitch to, how many people I meet on social media, how many people I'm speaking face-to-face. This is what I'm saying every single time. This is what works. This is what doesn't work. This is how many people are willing to watch a 35-minute intro presentation. And this is how many people are joining. This is how many people I take to head office. This is how many people I send the YouTube video to. This is how many people who come to my house. Be aware of those numbers. That is business. We don't operate by feel, yeah? Right? We have to conduct it responsibly as business. Be aware of those numbers so that you can become discerning to what works and what doesn't work, where the problem areas are, where you have to work on certain areas, right? To be unaware of that stuff, you're just drifting around. Okay? So be aware of the numbers always. But that is the premise. One person a week, two will join a month, 3 + 2 will get you to rank 9 in less than 2 years. Okay? Understanding the time frame. So there, it's spelt out for you. We see the exponential growth apparent here. It starts out slowly, right? Rank 2 is going to take you 4 months. This is where people give up. They give up because they look at the numbers. They say, I should be rich by now. It doesn't work like that. Leverage works like that, right? It's not a straight line. It works like that. It's slow in the beginning, and then it starts to ramp up. And we see it in the income that people earn here at Dewpoint. And so look, 165 jumps to 1,000. So that's a significant increase, right? To get to rank 9 after a year and 7 months, you're close to 17,000 Rand, right? These numbers will vary a little bit, but this is what the data shows us on average. If people remain engaged, this doesn't mean you take a month off. You take 3 months off a year, right? We worked this out. We looked at the data. You take 3 months off a year because we see people doing it. They get to November. Oh, it's holiday time. They stop doing work in November. December, they definitely don't do anything. January, they still don't do anything. That's 25% of the year that you've taken off. The effect that it has on leverage is drastic. It's not a linear reaction, right? You take 25% off a year out of this process, it sets you back by more than 50%. We don't take months off. Remember, the contract said 5 years endurance. 5 years, every single month. You're there for your first pointers every single day. 5 years in, it's going to be worth it. That's the question you have to answer. Is that worth it to me?
I work about 19 years for one company and I never earned the money that I've earned within the first 4 months in Dewpoint. Now the first year was really, really super. Within 4 months I reached what I wanted to do and then all of a sudden I reached a plateau. But I know that I just need to continue and do whatever I can do and the figures will and the numbers will come, and it did. They told me I'm crazy, this is never going to work, rather start something, join this and the other. And I said, no, one, I've decided that this is the way forward and I will stick to it until I reach my dreams.
Brenda's clinic said the first year it was fantastic. The second year, I got a bit distracted about it. You see, we tried everything, we talked to everything and nothing really happened. You see, and luckily we stuck to it, and that makes a big change at the end. We never, as you said, you never quit. You keep on keeping on all the time. Brendan, what I want to be in 2.5 years time is Bank 14. I think that's quite doable. It's going to be hard work, I know it, but if you don't work, nothing's going to happen. So I believe Rank 14 2.5 years, that'll be super.
I would say just do it. Keep on talking to people. I don't agree with you that it's difficult. It's easy. I can talk to anybody asking them, do you want to make money? Full stop. If they say yes, I send them the video. If they say no, I say thank you for their time.
That couple is the picture of endurance. Endurance. Endurance is not accepting that something is just going to be hard. endurance requires faith. It requires you to see something before you can see it. To have faith that you can achieve something when there are no signs that you're going to achieve it. Right? As they said, they had a whole year, an entire year where their business didn't grow. For whatever reason. Lynette was coming here for Teamworks every single month. Help me, I don't know what to do. What else can I do? But then, all of a sudden, her business just exploded. All that work she'd done. And now if you go listen to her testimonies now, she said she didn't realize it, but she was planting seeds. Those people were rejecting her, but she was planting seeds, planting seeds. Those people all came back to her. A year later, 2 years later, I want to join that business you told me about. 750 people in 1 month. Plant the seeds, right? That work does not go unrewarded. It only goes unrewarded when you quit. So, the decision slide again. We know the decision slide. It's been part of Dewpoint's intro presentation from day one. What is the decision? Everyone goes, oh, he's going to ask me to join. The decision slide again. Are you willing to sacrifice the time, overcome the frustration, and look past the rejection when you decide to do this business? Are you willing to endure? Is it worth enduring? This is an important question. Is it worth enduring? If you do not have a big enough reason why you're doing this, if that race does not scare you enough, you're going to quit because it's not worth it. The rejection is not worth it. The time required is not worth it. And so this leads me into vision. How do you see yourself in this business? What are your aspirations? Here's a lovely quote, Steve Jobs. If you are working on something that you really care about, you do not have to be pushed. The vision pulls you along. What is your vision in this business? I'll tell you what quitters think. Oh, Dewpoint's a quick way to make some cash. Ooh, I can be rich in 90 days. No appreciation of what endurance actually means. An easy way to engineer a free holiday at the end of the year. Ooh, they'll give me a car. People have missed the boat. They don't understand what we are trying to do with Dewpoint. Right? And so our job becomes to empower people's imaginations. To say to you that there is much more in store for you in this business than you even imagine. That's what I always say in the intro presentation. Let your imagination run wild. Imagine earning 85,000 rand a month. Imagine that day. Your account has been credited 85,000 rand. And you think, this is recurring income. They're going to do it again next month. Wow. And so what is Dewpoint's vision? What is our vision for this business? The construction of a new and separate Dewpoint economy. Is this not a business that affords people to increase their income every single month? What's happening outside of Dewpoint? Think about your salaries. Think about your circumstances at home. Think about our economy, all the people in South Africa, people globally, right? Being tossed around by the economy, feeling out of control. At Dewpoint, we aim to give you control, to allow you that accountability to do it for yourself. One in which South Africans, or all South Africans, are able to build recurring, sustainable, lifetime, generational wealth. That is the power of entrepreneurship, is that you get to do this for yourself, to build something that affords you wonderful benefits. One in which every South African, or any South African of any circumstance, can succeed. In the real world, we are marginalized constantly. Constantly. It is often only people with money that can get involved in entrepreneurship. It is only people that are educated, with degrees, with experience, with privilege, that are able to get salaries of this caliber. It's only these kind of people that get to go to Mauritius every single year. This business is designed to be accessible to every South African. That is our primary mandate. When we started the business, that was the number one goal. To afford people liberty, choice. We don't have choice. You don't have any choice. I often ask people, who can afford to lose their jobs? Who can afford to tell their boss, I don't like this job, I'm moving on? Or even say anything negative in a work environment because it'll be misconstrued and suddenly they're not even really interested or they don't enjoy it or they don't like the boss. Retrench them. Who can afford retirement? And then one does that not, that does not ask for money, but rather just time and desire and some effort. That's what we ask at Dewpoint. This is what the business is. This is our vision in the business. And to take that a step further, I was speaking to an audience during the launch workshop. I said, do you realize that what we're trying to achieve at Dewpoint? What you see here is not where we want to be. This is the beginnings. This is, Dewpoint is a sapling that's growing. Our aspiration is to become the greatest business opportunity in Africa. If you look at the biggest insurance companies in South Africa, that's where we're going. When you decide to partner with us, you decide to partner with that aspiration. What does that mean? That means in 20 years or 30 years or 40 years, as long as it takes, but when we get there, you're either going to be one of the stakeholders that has helped us do it, that has a significant share of that pie when we get there, or you're going to be one of the people that said, I wished I stayed in that business. The biggest insurance companies in South Africa, the owners are billionaires. Right? We have the luck of knowing somebody like that, someone who has that experience, that track record. Brendan's father built those businesses. He comes with that experience. He has designed this opportunity for all of us to get involved in. Don't look around at your circumstance now, how much you're earning at Dewpoint, and say, this is the ceiling. It's not the ceiling. We've only been around for 3.5 years. We have to have the vision of 30 years, of 40 years, of a lifetime. What happens if your children take over your channel and keep on building it? This is one of the things I just wish I could do. I just want to have a sneak peek. Just a sneak peek, 30 years into the future, of some of our biggest wealth engineers and what they've achieved. Like Patrick and Pumi. Right? Actually, I don't want to, there's a video coming up. They will tell you what their aspirations are when they talk about vision.
I did a lot of things in life. A lot of businesses. I tried. I was working. Things were not going well. Then one of my friends told me about network to say, I want to make a really money, because all along I didn't want to be poor. I wanted myself to be a rich guy.
I used to drive early in the morning, go to work, come back late in the evening, you see. And at that time I had a small baby and I was so worried that my child is going to know the helper more than knowing me. So the first question I asked him, with this business, how soon can I make 20,000? And he said, the more effort you put, the more money you're going to make. And I asked him, can I make more than 20,000? He said, the more effort you put, the more money we can make. So for us, especially network marketing, it gave us that moment to be able to build a family together, that moment to build future together, you know. I'm prepared to work hard for something that will give me great results in future.
In future, we want to be out of debt. I want to stay in a nice place. I want to drive the good car.
First goal, where we can say, we like, okay, phew, you know, is to get to 50,000. That one, that now we need to push like crazy because of the bills that we have, you see. And after 50,000, we need to get to 100,000. You know why? Because at 50,000, not that we're financial free, but we can be able to spend, I'll be able to spend every weekend, right? And go out as much as we want. The ultimate one, the most important one, we want to go and stay in Stain City. Yes, everyone's like, but yes, we're going there. We will.
I also want my car. I want a Bentley. After 5 years, I'll make sure I'll be having that car. I don't want to go with Pumi and with the family only. I want to see my first line, also qualifying to go to Mauritius, Cape Town. That's my dream. I want to see people's lives changing, not only for us.
With the experience we have with network marketing, we are sure and we know that is life-changing. We want people to join the vision that we have, because we know if they can join the vision that we have, especially with Dewpoint, we know they can go far. I think there's more power if everyone succeeds in the team. The opportunity has been given to everyone. It's the same opportunity. Come, join us on the vision. If you want help, call. We're here. Network marketing, you cannot do it alone. It's a teamwork.
We want to help them. We want them to grow. We want them to feel the same life that we're in.
That was their testimony. It was recorded in, I think, their 10th or 11th month at Dewpoint. That's already the belief and the faith they had in this business so long ago. And they achieved two of those things, right? They've already got a rank 9 wealth engineer on their first point, who went with them to Mauritius in their first year. They go rank 9 on the first day of every single month. Guys, you have to have this vision. It starts with belief. It doesn't start with looking around and going, oh yes, this is what I want. The vision is something you can't see, right? It has to pull you. It has to scare you. It has to motivate you to endure. The sun is going to set on all of our lives one day. You are going to die. All of us. Inevitable. And so the decision is, do I let life just dictate my circumstance and what I believe and the faith that I have, the vision that I develop, the attitude that I have through life? Do I let my circumstances dictate that to myself constantly? One of my favorite poems, probably my favorite poem, by Dylan Thomas, called Do Not Go Gentle Into That Good Night. Have a listen. I want you to listen to this. And I want to encourage you to not be passive. Stop being passive. Life is hard. We have to grab it by the horns. You have to, right? Passivity is dangerous. It creates apathy. People that don't rise up to the challenge. People that rather sit down and be spectators. The ones on the sidelines. The ones that decide never to enter the race. So listen to this poem. It's dictated by Anthony Hopkins.
Do not go gentle into that good night. Old age should burn and rave at close of day. Rage, rage against the dying of the light. Though wise men at their end know dark is right, because their words had forked no lightning, they do not go gentle into that good night. Good men, the last wave by, crying how bright their frail deeds might have danced in a green bay. Rage, rage against the dying of the light. Wild men who caught and sang the sun in flight and learned too late they grieved it on its way. Do not go gentle into that good night. Grave men near death who see with blinding sight, blind eyes could blaze like meteors and be gay. Rage, rage against the dying of the light.
We do not go out without putting up a fight. That's the message. And it starts on day one. A race starts with just the first step. You might start with no endurance. You might think to yourself, you know, I lack a little bit of confidence. I'm not one of these people that have endurance. It starts at day one. You can build all of that up for yourself. No one is born with endurance. But just enter the race. Enter the race knowing that you have all that support around you and that you can build up endurance so that one day when you look back, you go, this is how far I've come. When the sun is setting on your life, you can go, I put up a great fight. Because you'll have so much to show for it. And so I encourage you, right, for yourself and for your first pointers, reassess your vision, your understanding of what endurance is all about and what leverage affords you in this business, and make that decision again. That decision slide in our intro. It's not about joining. It's about your intention for yourself in this business and in this lifetime. Because we think we're affording you something that typically we would never be offered in a lifetime. And that is to change your life. So thank you. Go out and do it. Good luck. Did you like my poem?